Kakro, hallelujah.
Amen.
Etsu hini se hini yami, minu yei, obetsa mana soso. Yeah.
To the Lord Almighty. Louder! 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 Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Whatever which comes from my mouth, it is from the Word of God. I don't want to bring any worldly thoughts among our children of God. Even if it is pastor, bishop, or even the fellow workers. Because that is how the Lord is leading me, and I am tasting it in such a manner that I want you people also to taste it. Amen?
Amen.
I thought there is no interpreter, so I'll be getting the full time. But now there is an interpreter, so I'm getting half. Carry on. Amen?
Amen.
So, whatever the Holy Spirit is going to talk to you, take it. Because that is a blessing for you people. Amen?
Amen.
So the way of what the Lord is leading me is something different than what you see. Amen?
Amen.
So, don't expect the same thing what you have seen so far. This is something different with a short period. And with a short time, I'm just giving you a message. The message is not been prepared. What the Holy Spirit has given to me, I'm going to speak to you. Are you ready to receive it? Okay, somebody read for me from the book of Acts, chapter 20, verse 35. Acts 20, verse 35. Okay, I'll be reading it.
Acts 20, verse 35. And now behold, I know that ye all, among whom I have gone preaching the kingdom of God, shall see my face no more.
35.
Acts 20, verse 35.
35.
I have showed you all things, how that so laboring, ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of our Lord Jesus.
And
how
remember the word of our Lord, Jesus. And what is the word?
How he said, it is more blessed. To give than to receive.
To give than to receive. Amen.
Amen.
Are you ready to give? So that is being blessed. If you give, that is blessed. But if you are receiving it, it's not mentioned anything about that. So when I say give, I'm afraid to say that word. In Africa, you see, when you say that we have to give, you bring, take the money and give. I'm not talking about money. I'm not talking about monetary benefits. I'm not talking about cash or anything like that. But mainly it's for the person's
the people who is going to receive that award today. And those who are into this divine world preaching the good news. And for those who are already the members of this Jesus Christ congregation, it is for each one of you. Brothers, it is for you. And sisters, it is for you. Workers of the Lord, it is for you. It includes me also. So the word of God says that it is better to give than to receive. So what is it? What is it you have to give? Can you read for me from the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 8? Matthew, chapter 10, verse 8.
Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely ye have received, freely give.
Can you read word by word?
Heal the sick.
Heal the sick.
Cleanse the lepers.
One moment. People normally read it faster.
So you can in terms of
each and every word, that is a meaning, there is something in that. Each and every footstop and comma, there is a meaning and something in that. Maybe the footstop is talking to you. Maybe the full stop is talking to you. Maybe the comma is talking to you. Maybe one of the words is talking to you. Whichever which is talking to you, just take it inside. And in your life, do it practically in your life.
Now we are to talk.
Amen.
Amen.
So it says, what did it say?
Heal the sick.
Heal the sick. But you should have the gift of that healing.
And let just say,
amen.
Amen.
I give thanks to the Lord for my name is Antony Walto.
So Antony
will call me Walto.
Do you friend Walto?
In front of my name there are so many letters. After my name is also there are so many letters. Which I don't carry and doesn't want to declare to anybody. Because I give thanks to the Lord Almighty.
No, yes, that might be the same.
Before I could get these letters front and back, the Lord was graceful enough to give me the gifts of the Holy Spirit. It is not one gift, it's not two gifts, it's not three gifts. He has given the gift and I have tasted it and I have seen it in front of me. So whatever which comes in front of my name and after my name is not important at all. Of course, in the world we have some systems. And I too receive that kind of honor which has been given to me from a different part of the world. Just because they honor me, I normally honor them also by receiving it. I just bring it home and I file it and keep it there. Only that congregation who has honored me and I know what exactly has taken place. I don't carry it around the world with that particular honor. But I carry what the Holy Spirit gives to me.
Amen.
Amen. So it says, heal the sick. How many of you are here who can heal the sick? Amen.
Amen.
Okay. The Lord God says, I'm going to give you the gift. If you're ready to take it,
so why you can't solve it
in such a manner. And if you have the faith in such a manner,
so said,
when you start laying your hand to a sick person without your knowledge, the healing will take place in such a manner where you get the confirmation from the person who has been healed, and not only from that person, from the people who have seen what has taken place during your sermon, and when they come to you, it is not an honor to you. Give thanks to the Lord for what they have done to you. So what is next?
cleanse the lepers,
heal the sick and raise the dead. Amen.
Amen.
Wow. It is not a symbol. I'm just praying for my Lord. Lord, you have given me so many gifts. Give me the gift of raising the dead. Amen.
Amen.
I don't have money to have a big crusade.
So this is going to be a crusade case.
Out of 100,000 or 200,000 people are there, some healing takes place. And when the crowd is eager to receive that particular gift, and the crowd is ready to receive the healing, it is not the man of God who is on the pulpit who is doing that. It is the Holy Spirit which is carrying, which is doing that purpose. Same thing if there is a death. And if I can do that,
that's what you mean, and then if you're
just praying to the Lord, give me that gift. But unfortunately, sorry to tell everybody.
So for so catching,
I've been to so many countries.
Not only African,
UK, US, Australia, and all these places also. But I see every churches have the same mentality. They doesn't want to change at all. Even when they see the signs and wonders which is taking place in front of us. Still, when the meeting is over, they just go back home, they forget everything. It is not only really happening in Africa, it is happening in Europe countries, in the US and in Australia also.
And yet you remember
so one thing what I found out is even spirit is saying everywhere. He has entered the church and is doing the same thing everywhere. Just because I'm traveling, I can identify this. Those are still in Africa, Ghana, they look about Ghana's time. But if it is a different African country, they look about that side.
So once
you travel around the world, you will find what exactly is taking place.
So that
is why it is bold enough for me to talk to you directly. What the Lord has given to me and what has been taking place in front of me, I want that to take place in you people. And let the blessing and the sign and what was take place among you. Don't do the formalities. And those are receiving the awards today. When they receive the award, it is a blessing from the leaders of your people who wants to honor you in front of the public. Maybe the public doesn't know you people. So the ownership is given to these people. It is a confirmation that he is such and such and such and such and person. But that is not going to do anything in your divine field. Amen.
Amen.
It is only for a confirmation for the public. But to do the divine purpose in front of the people and the public, you will have to receive from above. Not from the Bible college. Not by from your church. Not from different churches. But kneel down. Pray to the Lord Almighty. Give that to provide that particular gift. So that takes place among you. And signs and wonders will take place among you. Amen.
Amen.
So what is next? Let us cast out demons. You receive without pain. You have received that gift without paying a single penny. I give thanks to the Lord for I did not even pay a single penny. Maybe that is why the Lord has kept my children well in advance. In such a manner that expenses are met by my children. Wherever I travel, my flight ticket, my visa cost
is paid
by my children. And some occasions, some countries, including the hotel convention and food
transferred, everything is taken care by
me. But I say that what has been received,
I receive it free. Are you ready to do that?
Why can't you serve inside?
If you are ready to receive,
why can't you serve everybody?
If you are ready to receive the gifts of the Holy
Spirit, why can't you serve everyone not here?
And if you have received it,
don't cancel it.
Don't sell it.
And Tom at here.
Never sell it.
And find you and find more
people. Nowadays, people have a meeting.
And
they say a registration fee of some dollars and some dollars. If you want to listen to the word of God, you have to pay from your pocket.
When
you go through the word of God, you don't find that. So whatever you have received, just give it free. You are receiving an award.
And then
the congregation is honoring you. You just give it free what you have received. Are you ready for it? Are you ready for it? So where do you get this free? Somebody read for me from Gospel of John 14:14. Chapter 14, verse 14. Make it first. Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 14. Amen.
Verse 14.
John 14, verse 14. 1:4. You ask anything in my name. And Lord God says that you ask anything in my name. I will ask my Father, and he will give it for you. And it is not for money. It is free. It is free. And then when you come to chapter 15, I mean verse 15.
Say verse 15.
What is that you are going to get free? It's the another comforter. Which you don't get it from the world. Even if you sell everything, you don't get it. It is free. Provided how you ask. When you start asking,
it's
going to be a different comforter. When you have received that comforter, spiritual gifts started building up in you. The Lord God says, I'm going to give you a spirit, another comforter, something different what you are holding now, where you will be surprised, your church will be surprised, your family will be surprised. This was not taking place earlier. And how is it happening today? The Lord has chosen
you
with a special gift. Whenever you come for a meeting, when the word of God comes from your tongue, when you read a paragraph of something from the word of God, what is read from the word of God, you are not teaching them. What is read from the word of God that is going to take place in front of you? Are you ready to receive it? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Receive the gift. When you receive the award. When you receive the award.
So you
are receiving it. But what are you going to give it back? So to give it back, you have to be holding these spiritual gifts. Because it is free what you receive. When you have received it free, be bold enough to give it free. Amen.
Amen.
Are you ready for it?
Why, God?
Give a thanks offering to the Lord. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Be on your feet.
Yes, sir.
Be on your feet.
Yes, sir.
Speak to the Lord. Speak to the Lord. I want the special comforter. I need the special comforter.
Fill me with a special comforter. Allow me to please the comforter. Now God says, allow me to place the comforter. Yes. Receive. Pray. The Lord God says, receive. Yes. Award ceremony. When those who have been selected to receive the awards,
the
others who have not receiving anything from you as an award, speak to the Lord. Allow me to receive the special comfort. And He is going to fill it for you. Amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Give a clap of hand to the Lord Almighty.
Louder!
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, those who have heard this word of God, the Spirit which is from the Father, another Comforter which is from the Father, give them the courage, the grace to receive you. Bless them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Finish the program very soon. So, be calm. Amen. And before I proceed, I'm calling upon the director, the engineer of King of Kings Web Foundation. He is the managing director of King of Kings Web Foundation. King of Kings Web Foundation. Which consists of which consists of King of Kings Foundation Academy, that is school for orphans and the needy, King of Kings Bible Training College, and also King of Kings Health Training College, King of Kings Vocational Training Institute, the Ordained Christian Ministers Association, and it's a lot that this man of God carries. So please, let's be on our feet as I welcome the director of Business Development. As I welcome onto the podium the director, King of this amazing Bishop Dr. Joseph Kadu Asante.
I'm in love with my Jesus. I shall not want to be a slave like that.
Amen.
Amen.
Before I give a speech, I would like to use this opportunity to introduce to us some dignitaries. First of all, I want you to understand that we are here in the name of King of Kings World Foundation, and we have invited some people to join us today. So without wasting time, I would like to introduce to us the one that is coming to represent Rescue Historical University, USA. He is the Africa Director, and I also work under him, and he is here today. To run, we do that easy, we nearly listen, because things were very, very late. But by the grace of God, they have just arrived. So I want us to recognize the presence of Reverend Professor Greg Stevens. He is also the Vice Chancellor of Rescue Institute University. So what should we tell you? You are welcome. Amen. We also have Ebora in our list, who invited him purposely for this program. And he is an Indian by
Doctor.
Sorry.
Dubai.
Beth, and he's been at Malaysia, and now he's based in Dubai. And this is a friend of ours, a brother of ours, a partner of ours. That's what we are doing, we're inviting the camps. So I want us to recognize the person of Reverend Dr. Antony Walto. What should we tell him? Then we also speak to him. Amen. We have Archbishop-elect Nathaniel Eze from Nigeria. He is a brother and a friend of ours. We work together. He has a ministry. He's an international preacher. He has a ministry. He has organizations. And today he's here. So you are welcome.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
we have Apostle Dr. K.K. Yabwa in our midst. A friend of ours. Amen. He was once awarded by King of Kings World Foundation National Awards. He's doing very well. After the awards, still he's doing well. So today, at the grace of God, he's here. I think we didn't invite him, but one of the candidates of today invited him. And, we are also blessed to have him at this point. You are welcome, sir. You're welcome. Amen. We have Apostle Mauli Kwame Mauko in our midst. He's here. Amen. By the grace of God, he is the founder and the general overseer of Glory of Heaven International Ministry here as we are. He is the one. Discipline Committee Chairman of the Obey Christian Minister Sushi, which I'm the founder, and by the grace of God, he is myself as well. I'm proud of him because he's doing very well and God is using him. So, Apostle, God bless you. God bless you. We have one of our board members in our list. The rest will be coming. We have Reverend Dr. Moses Kosi Atibo in our midst. He is a member of
World Cancer of the King of Israel Foundation. He's also lecturing at the Bible College, he's at Adam Dean Bible College. We have Dr. Rebecca Akash is not here. We have Mrs. Lester Santos is not here. And I'm also here. Amen. So because of time, I just want to speak briefly about
Hallelujah. We heard Dr. Walto telling us about the source of honor, because if you can't identify your source, if you can't recognize your source, then you will have no footing. The Holy Spirit is the epitome, is the one that leads us to what? To honor. So thank God for Dr. Walto. Everywhere he goes in the world, he's presenting this man, the Holy Spirit. I tell the world that the Holy Spirit is the man you need to know, because your knowledge of the Holy Spirit will change your perception, will change everything around you. I pray for us before I begin, that before you leave this service, like Apostle Paul, he said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. I pray that after this meeting, you will know God better.
Amen.
Can I hear a better amen?
Honorary doctorate. And it will not be one, it will be in different faculties according to what we heard about them. Amen.
Amen.
Having fulfilled all these, Kings of Kings, World Foundation, and Rescue Mission Theological University, USA, are proud of you to confer on you honoring a doctorate degree in ministry.
Oh, clap your hands. Let's rope in. We can't talk about honor without having the decoration. The Chinese proverb says that it's only the fool that rejects honor.
On behalf of the Board of Rescue Institute of University, this afternoon, I present to you Dr.
Ejale Andrew.
Ejale Andrew. Doctor. This After on behalf of King of Peace World Foundation and Rescue Mission to Uganda University, I present to you Apostle Peter S. O. Oloye.
King of Kings, World Foundation and Rescue Mission, Theological University, U.S. of A. I'm proud of you to confer on you an honorary doctorate degree in divinity.
I, Reverend Professor Grace, speaking on behalf of the Governing Council, Senate Board, Academic Dean of the School, wish to admit you, Prophet John Antony Walto, to the College of Doctor of Divinity of Rescue Mission Theological University.
On behalf of King of Kings World Foundation and International Africa Christian Leadership Award, I present to you Africa Honorary Award Certificates. Presenting a gift to you for the good work that you are doing. As you see, it's motivating to do more. At the same time, you will back it up this World Foundation. On behalf of King of Kings, I'm proud of you to confer on you honorary doctorate degree in administration.
I'm proud of you to confer on you.
Hallelujah. Please, everybody should come in and then see our newly doctors. Doctors, this afternoon you are welcome in the name of Jesus. We want to welcome you into the College of Doctors Association. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hello, please bring your minds here. What we do is we are teachers. As we have awarded you doctors, you can go. You mention doctor, add it to your particulars, whatsoever, you are free to do that. Amen.
Amen.
Now, we have another area that you would like to join the College of Doctors. If you join the College of Doctors, as you are doing a program, the doctors, as you invite them, they will come, whether good or bad, and they will come with their contributions. You become a member of International College of Doctors. It's like Medical Doctors Association. That is how it is. But